Welcome, my friend. I leave the floor to you.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Luqman, respected moderator, fellow distinguished panelists, His Excellency, the Ambassador of the State of Palestine to Malaysia, Mr. Walid, His Excellency, Mr. Amar and Dr. Mumtaz, as well as friends. I think being the last speaker, I'm very much privileged. One, because I'm being preceded by a panel of very distinguished scholars who have actually highlighted the audience with many of the issues of concern with respect to this decision. But perhaps one issue that I can share with the audience tonight is my own understanding of the decision, and a little bit of that, and what actually the message that the civil society organizations in the whole world must carry in order to move forward with the campaign, this ICC campaign for the state of Palestine. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most contentious issues raised particularly by those who hold the view that the ICC lacks territorial jurisdiction over Palestine was that if it was ruled that such territorial jurisdiction existed, then the ruling would prejudice the question of any future borders between the state of Palestine, between the state of Palestine and Israel, or would be adjudicating a border dispute, which is an issue beyond the court scope. And specifically, I from my understanding, I think in this specific decision, the ICC has effectively made a determination on the matter for the single purpose of helping define the jurisdiction of the court, and not for the purposes of helping define the international borders between Israel and Palestine. This is my understanding. And simply put, I think that the court was not attempting to adjudicate the ongoing border dispute between the Palestine and Israel under international law. Neither was the court trying to prejudice the question of any future borders. The reality is that those issues and almost certainly will need to be addressed at some point in the future. However, these are already clearly beyond the court's scope. The one aspect that is within the constitutional competence of the ICC is determining issues of statehood that would not bind the international community. But if there is one message that I want to share with the audience tonight is that I want to urge, as already stated by His Excellency Mr. Amar from the beginning of the presentation, that we need, and I urge the international community to support the ICC process, because there has been no, I think at least in the Asia-Pacific area, I see that there has been not much support in favor of the decision. There has been much criticism. We hear that many countries are in fact condemning the decision as it has become political, which I think is not the case. I think countries and our role as civil society organizations, we must urge the international community to support the ICC process, respect the decision of the pre-trial chamber, and let the Office of the Prosecutor to actually continue and commence and continue their investigation immediately, as directed by the court. And we need to remind ourselves, even if we refer to the preamble of the Rome Statute, which calls for international cooperation to ensure the lasting respect for and the enforcement of international justice. And only by allowing this process to take place independently and professionally by the Office of the Prosecution, then we will be able to achieve the objective of ending impunity and pursuing justice, which I think ultimately the long-term aim, only by ending impunity and pursuing justice, that it will bring us closer to peace in the Middle East, which is a very important question. And I think we see also the failure of other UN political organs to actually try to find a solution towards the problem. So ICC is perhaps a very encouraging move. And for us, the NGOs in the South Pacific region, I think for my ATSA, because I was invited to participate and help and assist the legal team, I think that is, and this is the a very excellent opportunity for us to actually try to convince even our non-Muslim NGOs, because this is not a question of only a Muslim issue, but this issue, this humanity issue, must also, I mean, we must also call upon our non-Muslim friends, yeah, to support this decision because of their recognition also of the international process, because of their recognition of the ICC process. So I think if there is one message that I want to share with the audience tonight, and perhaps I can, we should allow for question and answers from the audience, because it's already 10 o'clock and I believe that the audience have burning questions that they want to pose to the speakers. But I think there is one message that I try to bring tonight is, I urge the international community, I urge Malaysian-based NGOs, Asia-Pacific NGOs, to actually respect the process, participate in the process. And I believe that MyAXA, being a leading NGO in this specific issue in Malaysia, we are most welcoming. Yeah, we are most welcoming other friends from other NGOs to actually help us and assist us in moving forward in this campaign. Perhaps I will leave the floor to Q&A, and we can listen from the audience their views on some of the issues that have been raised by the speakers. Thank you, Mr. Luqman.